so much of what I've done in the last few years has been around other psychologists who study teaching and learning. And so I don't think I realize that there are so many people who are involved in higher education who are interested in the same questions that I am, but are coming at it from different perspectives. So it was really interesting to meet people, for example, who are running entire community college systems and using data to inform their approach to that. It's been exciting to meet people who are doing large-scale assessment at their university, to meet vendors who have access to all of these data coming in through their platforms that they can use to make design decisions. So it's been really exciting to see that there's this really broader community of people who share my goals and interests that I can plug into.
So people who are interested in asking research-based questions and taking a research-informed process to the types of activities that we're doing. So it's how it informs our work rather than the types of institutions. I love the diversity of the institutions and the opportunity not only to talk to individuals from other community college and other access institutions, but also to learn from what the research institutions and the what the 4 years are doing. Because I think there's a lot of collaboration that can happen and looking at the resources that they may have available in the sense of the data scientists and access to how we work with the data moving forward.
As a very large system, we have the ability to provide, we reflect the diversity of our country, of our state, of the population. We accept the top 100% of students, and so therefore, you know, we're able to, at scale, you know, prove some of the research theories or disprove them, and help researchers from our, you know, partner institutions, you know, better understand in practice how their research can be deployed and get a lot of great data back about that. So we really give them the ability to deploy potential solutions, whether it's a vendor partner, whether it's a researcher, and understand what that means at scale with a very diverse population.
Success for us, I guess, would be starting to get help with the things that we can't do, right? You know, as a vendor, especially as a small vendor in comparison to some of the other guys, we have pretty limited resources, and we have limited time and things like that, and limited knowledge. There are definitely things that that academics and other vendors can do that we can't do. So, you know, making progress on the kind of problems that we're interested in, understanding how to use educational technology effective, any kind of progress on those kind of things will be success for us.
One of the big problems I see in the space right now with researchers on one side and vendors or tool providers on the other side is that there is a disconnect in what we know and what we can do together. So, for example, researchers have theories about how learning works and what kind of interventions might support student success in an online environment. Vendors have access to a lot of students and the technology and the abilities to implement some of those interventions. So pairing those two together can really bootstrap the progress that we can make in science and understand when interventions are working, for whom they are working, and develop something we really need in education, which is a science of context, understanding under what circumstances for what groups of students given learning interventions work. And I think together is the only way to achieve this, because there's resources on both sides, the theories, the scientific method on the researcher's side, and the data, the access, and the engineering resources on the vendor side.
I think one of the biggest, loftiest goals that I see being possible, it may take a longer time than a year to get there, is the idea of culture change, is the idea of helping to perpetuate a culture of empirical education, which happens at lots of levels. It happens at the level of getting instructors to think about the value of data, getting administrators to think about encouraging the value of data, getting vendors and educators working together to align their interests and get better data to inform practices. So that culture change, I think, is a really, really big goal. And some of the ways I would see us making progress toward that would be first having a number of new projects that have been sparked. So new research efforts that involve partnerships across these different goals, across these different people, so vendors working with educators. That would be one thing I'd want to see. Another might be new sets of tools that we could use that would make it easier for others to take these types of approaches as well. Maybe they're tools for data sharing. Maybe they're tools for data analysis, for visualizing data. Maybe they're tools for finding collaborators. Those would be some, I think, simple accomplishments too that would be moving us toward this culture change, this culture shift. I think it might also be interesting to have, even a kind of broader conference or creating more educational opportunities for people to come together the way that we have. So we've had this amazing opportunity. Could we create that opportunity for other people? Maybe it's by having a mini presence at other conferences. Maybe it's by having our own conference. So that would be another thing that I could see being a potential outcome. But at the very minimum, new projects, new collaborations, new tools, I think is something we can definitely do.
I think we will see far more instances across the network of people working in an outcomes-focused, evidence-based, evidence-building way. And it could be through individual practice, it could be through developing tools and resources that facilitate greater impact and change at scale, or it could be through a combination of both of those things. And I'm really excited to find out what it's going to look like, because we're in the process now of building a plane while we're flying it, and that's exciting. And I think it's going to lead to a lot of different flowers blooming that will contribute to what it means to be part of the EEP in the future.